guys, it's Kim here. Welcome back to my channel. I'm here in Harajuku. So in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys fun things that you can do. Let's go. We are in front of the gates to the entrance of Meiji Jingu Shrine. Now it's one of the most famous shrines in Tokyo and it's close to the train station. So it's nice to kind of get away from the hustle and bustle in Harajuku to go and see something traditional. Now from these gates, it's about a 15 minute walk to the shrine. It does close at 4 p.m. so make sure you get there before and factor in the walk. It's a beautiful
Meiji
walk
Jingu
though,
so is really a shrine dedicated to Emperor Meiji and his wife. This stunning shrine is located around 10 minutes from Harajuku Station in Yoyogi Park. Take a lovely walk under the shade of trees before you get to the shrine. This is a perfect getaway from the bustle in Harajuku. The grounds and the buildings of the shrine themselves are peaceful and beautiful. The area has a museum and gardens that can also be visited, but these have to be paid for, though the shrine is free. Next is Yoyogi Park. It's a popular public park known for its rich history, diverse attractions, and cultural significance. It's also one of the best spots for hanami in Tokyo. During March and April, there are around 700 cherry blossom trees in full bloom, which attract visitors from all over Japan and makes it a very popular tourist destination in spring. There's lots of events on the weekends, and the park also provides a dog run, making it a favorite spot for dog lovers in the city. The atmosphere here is really nice and the park is beautiful in every season. Takashitadori. Takashita Street is a vibrant and exciting destination to go for your Japan trip. The lively atmosphere and colorful shops make it an unforgettable experience. We did try some of the shops and street food on offer here and it was just so much fun. It's a must-see destination for anyone visiting Tokyo and looking for a fun and memorable experience. Next, Purikura. Purikura is the perfect way to capture memories in Japan with your friends. In Takashita Street, you can find these big halls filled with various Purikura booths, each having a different and unique style. The booths are equipped with a variety of features that allow you to take photos and customize them the way you like after the photos are printed out in a form of either a small strip or even some photo cards that you can share with your friends. It's a perfect way to remember your trip to Japan. Kiddyland. The flagship store of Kiddyland is located in the middle of Harajuku. Kiddyland is particularly known for its huge selection of character merchandise. It offers a wide variety of toys and products featuring popular Japanese characters, anime franchises, and international brands. This includes items related to Hello Kitty, Pokemon, Disney, Sanrio, Studio Ghibli, and many more. No matter your age, Kiddyland has something for everyone. Next is Gachapon. Seaplu Harajuku has a great selection of gacha machines and they're such a cool variety. It's two stores full of gacha machines that are usually arranged by different themes. You can find Disney, Pokemon, Sanrio and more. The store is bright and colorful and it's just such a fun place to discover new and rare gacha toys. Even just looking through the machines was fun enough as they were carrying different kinds of interesting and crazy gachas. Now look, you may think that a lot of these things are useless, but there are some machines that have some very useful gachapons. So for example, I decided to try and get this dog treat bag, which I've been using for quite a while to put my dog's treats in there when I go take her out for a walk. It's very convenient.
New treat bag for Hina. Thank you.
Cat Street. Cat Street is lined with a variety of independent boutiques, designer shops, and concept stores. Along Cat Street, you'll find a range of cafes, restaurants, and food stands offering a diverse culinary experience. Whether you're looking for a quick bite or a coffee, there are plenty of options to choose from. Now, Cat Street is very different from Takeshitadori in Harajuku. Cat Street is located in a little back street right between Aoyama and Harajuku, and the vibe is a bit more mature. Cafe Reissue. Even if you are not into coffee, this cafe is worth a visit for the unique 3D latte art. The latte art looks amazing, and you can choose from various characters from the English menu, or just show them a picture of the latte art you'd like to have. They have a very unique seating system, so when you go to the cafe, tell the staff the time you'd like to come, they'll reserve you a table, and in the meantime, you can go explore the other parts of Harajuku. You unfortunately cannot book online, so you have to go on a day. Shiba Inu Cafe. The Mame Shiba Cafe offers a cozy and relaxing atmosphere where visitors can enjoy drinks while interacting with the adorable dogs. So Mame means bean in Japanese, and it is used to describe things that are small or tiny. So a Mame Shiba Inu is a specific variation of the classic Japanese Shiba Inu breed, which is characterized by their smaller size. To get in, you need to get a ticket with a time slot, and you later come back at the designated time and enjoy some dog company. Lishina. In the middle of Takeshita Street in Harajuku, you can find rainbow-themed foods at Lishina. They offer colourful rainbow corn dogs and rainbow cheese sandwiches, as well as more rainbow-themed snacks and drinks.
We got our rainbow toast. Now let's pull it apart. Ooh. Ooh. Look at these colours. Yes!
That's good.
This is so good. Now, I'll be honest, there's nothing special about this. It's just colored cheese and bread. But I love cheese toasties. You can never go wrong with a cheese toastie, guys.
Totti Candy. Totti Candy's oversized and visually stunning cotton candy creations make them highly Instagrammable and perfect for photo opportunities. The vibrant colors, generous size, and different flavors make it really unique. The flavors include melon, ramune, strawberry, grape, and lemon. It is really big, but it's enough to share with your friends, and honestly, it was really good.
We are in front of the Galaxy store, and there is a Team Lab collaboration. It's free to enter, so let's go check it out.
Samsung Galaxy store. Now, did you know you can enjoy a free Team Lab exhibition in the middle of Harajuku? At the Samsung Galaxy store, you can enjoy a one-of-a-kind TeamLab exhibition that changes depending on the season. So when I went, it was an underwater theme where they give you a Samsung phone to enjoy, and it's kind of like catching Pokemon, which is really cool. The staff is English speaking, and you can also check out their regular products, as well as a cafe and seasonal events. Anakuma Cafe is known for its unique bear-themed decor and atmosphere. So to order, you use the tablet that is just on the side of the store, and I guess the bear behind the wall will make the drinks and will serve it to you. I've never seen this kind of concept before for a cafe, so this is really new and exciting. The cafe offers drinks for takeaway, and it just includes a variety of different hot and cold drinks, coffee, tea, smoothies. So yeah, would you like to try a drink made by a bear too?
So we are at Anakuma Cafe, and you get served by a bear here. You order on a tablet, and then once you pay for your order, the bear is going to give you your drink. Now the bear sometimes puts out his hand to, you know, interact with you.
Aperiti. Thank you. Kuma.
It's really hot. Oh my gosh. I think this is a very unique idea for a cafe. And to be honest, the prices are quite expensive, but it's for the experience. And the drink is actually pretty good.
Daiso. Daiso is a popular discount store chain in Japan that is known for its budget-friendly prices, and most of the items are priced at 100 yen, which is approximately around $1 USD. One of Tokyo's biggest Daisos is located in Takeshita Street in Harajuku. Daiso stores typically offer a diverse range of products like household goods, kitchenware, bathroom essentials, home decor, beauty, skincare products, snacks, and so much more. The Daiso is particularly popular amongst tourists for its selection of cheap Japanese souvenirs and stationery items. On top of that, Daiso often introduces seasonal or limited edition products, especially during holidays or special occasions. Longer Longest is a store on Takeshita Street selling snacks in three sizes. You can enjoy cotton candy, churros, and potato tornadoes. It's basically a really long fried potato on a stick. I got the butter shoyu flavor in the longest size.
Potato chips, and I'm kind of regretting it. I didn't expect it to be so big, but oh my gosh, this is like gonna fall on me. Alright, we're going to try our potatoes. This is 52 centimeters long. It's like half a meter.
Strawberry Fetish. The sugar-coated strawberries at Strawberry Fetish in Takashita Street are so popular that they were even featured on Japanese television. Now, the strawberries were slightly more sour, which I thought was perfect to counteract the sweetness so it just doesn't overwhelm you. So yeah, I could have eaten multiple of these.
I got the strawberry and green grape. It's just coated in candy. It kind of reminds me of a toffee apple. So let's give it a shot. It's really hard. That's actually pretty good. It's not very sweet because the fruit kind of balances out with the acidity. That's so good.
Peanuts Cafe. This cafe is a must go to if you're a fan of Snoopy and his friends. It's located in one of Harajuku's quieter side streets. In this adorable cafe, you can get unique peanuts themed snacks, sweets, and drinks. They offer a variety of savory and sweet dishes. I got the toast with bacon and egg and also the Snoopy pancake. The pancake was so good and it was adorable. The interior is really cute and simple, and they are also selling a lot of different merchandise as well. You can get a variety of Snoopy themed goods, including things like tumblers, notebooks, kitchenware, lunchboxes, many more. Now, it does get busy on the weekends, so you can also get some drinks and snacks for takeaway. There's also outdoor seating available, and of course, it's full of cute Snoopy decorations. Meepig. Located on a quiet street on the side of Takeshita Street, Meepig is a unique cafe where you can interact with micro pigs. You do have to book in advance, which can be easily done online on the website. It is 660 yen for the entry fee, plus 1,100 yen for a 30-minute session. As you enter the cafe, you can store your belongings in the lockers provided. This was the first time doing something like this for me, so it was really exciting. There's also a drink machine inside that you can use for yourself. I visited alone, but the staff were very accommodating and spent time explaining to me the different personalities of each micro pig. Blankets are provided so they can sit comfortably on your lap. Be patient as you wait for the micro pigs to approach you. Once they do, more will eventually want to snuggle with you. It seems like the bigger pigs wanted to sit on my lap instead of the small ones. Luckily, I'm used to this because of my dog, but this was such a unique experience that you won't get anywhere else. Tokyu Plaza. Tokyu Plaza is a multi-story department store known for its iconic entrance. Designed by an architect, the mirrored telescope provides a great backdrop for photos. My favorite part of this department store is actually level 6 where the Starbucks is located. There is a spacious terrace with a really beautiful view of Harajuku. It's the perfect place to relax after you've just walked around the busy Harajuku streets, and it's just a must go, I think.
Our last stop for tonight is Harajuku Crepes. So there are so many stores down Takeshita Dori that sell these crepes, and they are delicious, so let's grab one. We got our crepe. There are so many different choices, as you can see, but I got the blueberry cheesecake, so let's give it a shot. It is actually really light. This is a cheesecake, and it's so soft. You've got the whipped cream, the sauce. The perfect way to end the night. That is the end of today's video. I hope hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please remember to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so yet, and also follow me on all my social media, which will be linked down below. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye guys.